Lady Clotilde, is it time for you to depart?
Yes, I'll be stepping out for a while. But more importantly, who do we have here?
Is that... No way!
The Vita Clotilde?
Whoa! I can't believe it! It's really her!
I never thought I'd actually get the chance to meet her.
Wait, who is this now?
You three! Don't just stand there staring! You're in the presence of the legendary opera singer Vita Clotilde! The Azure Diva herself!
The Azure Diva, huh? I do recall hearing that name at some point.
Wait, you don't know who she is?
I'm not surprised. Opera is a world unto itself. I expect there are multitudes who have never heard of me before. I'm Vita Clotilde, an opera singer. I'd be delighted if you would come and hear me sing sometime.
Bring it on!
I'll handle it.
Got it.
Laura, let's go.
Understood.
My turn. Keep it up, everyone.
Here we go. All right, let's do this.
Guys, me.
My turn. Here we go. Got it.
An opening. My turn. Now.
Broken.
Oh, no, you don't.
That takes care of them. Well, that was... You know, maybe you should just stop worrying about trying to form a combat link with each other.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I can see why you'd really want to.
No. I don't want to hold our group back more than I already have. I'd like to withdraw from active combat and take a more supporting role for the duration of this field study.
Huh? Why?
But Laura, it doesn't make any sense for you not to be in the thick of the fight.
Don't be ridiculous. If anyone should be benched, it's me. It makes sense when you consider what each of us brings to a fight.
No. My own immaturity is the cause of this. There's still a part of me that refuses to accept you, and this is the result. I'm sorry. I didn't think I was this narrow-minded. And I apologize for the distress my prejudice has no doubt been causing you. I came to realize during my club activities that I still have a lot of maturing left to do.
Laura.
As such, Reen, I wish to withdraw.
Denied. Actually, I'll be the one withdrawing from frontline combat.
Huh?
Reen?
This seems awfully sudden. What's your line of thinking?
During all the battles we fought, one thing stood out to me. I couldn't help but notice that under ordinary circumstances, Laura and Fee's fighting styles complement each other perfectly.
Well,
you think so?
Interesting. What do you mean?
Laura's the ideal knight, standing strong in the thick of the fight, dominating enemies with her blade. And there's Fee, the ideal vanguard, overwhelming the opposition with her speed and creating openings for Laura. During the practical exam, none of us should have stood a chance against the two of you.
When you put it that way, it does make sense.
If they could form a combat link, they'd be virtually unstoppable.
Yeah, I don't think that's escaped you two either. That's why you keep trying to form a combat link, but there's something stopping you from connecting with each other. Whatever it is, it's been frustrating both of you this whole time, right?
Mm-hmm. It's exactly as you say.
Okay, so, since that's how things stand, it makes no sense for you two to just give up and withdraw from combat. In fact, considering everyone's relative strengths and weaknesses, it makes the most sense for me to fall back. This way, you'll have more chances to work out whatever it is that's standing in the way of you forming a link.
You have my thanks.
We'll take you up on your offer then.
That's what I like to hear.
We really can be audacious sometimes, you know. Just like you were with me and Eustace.
You think? I don't really think I did anything out of the ordinary.
That's so you, Rain, to not think anything of it. Still, thanks to you, there might be hope for these two after all.
We'll do what we can.
But first, we need to get back to the hotel, right?